this would be our mission. Kamusta mga bata? Hope you're fine and safe. Welcome to our science class week 5. For this week class, atuwa usang ansira ng inyong summative test na gikuha last week. Pagkahuman atog check, chikan pud nato ang inyong assessment on module 2 lesson 1, separating mixtures through filtering and sieving. And after that, we will discuss your lesson 2 in your module 2. Separating mixtures through evaporation. So, mauni atong ubrahon for this week. Okay, this time, we will answer first your summative test. Okay, please get your notebook in science. Diba, akong isulti nga inyuhang kopyahon ang inyuhang answer sa inyuhang summative test sa notebook ninyo, diba? Ang katong ming online, okay, kuning kopya ka sa imong answer, pwede ra pod nimo makuha imong notebook. Okay? Pero I'm sure kabalo na ka kung pila ang imuhang score kay ning online summative test ka. Okay? So please get your notebook now. Okay, this is your offline summative test in science. Question number 1. Which of the following statements describes mixture? A. It is a particular kind of matter with uniform properties. Letter B. It is a substance that is made entirely from one type of atom. Letter C. It is the combination of two materials without any chemical changes or reaction. Letter D. It is metal made by combining two or more metallic elements, especially to give greater strength or resistance to corrosion. What is your answer? The correct answer for number 1 is letter C. It is the combination of two materials without any chemical changes or reaction. Question number 2. Which describes homogeneous mixture? A. Homogeneous has three or more substances. Letter B. Homogeneous looks the same throughout. C. Homogeneous has different parts. Letter D. Homogeneous has two or more faces. What is the correct answer? The answer is letter B. Very good. Homogeneous looks the same throughout. Number 3. If you can easily see the different parts that make up a mixture, you know that it is a blank mixture. A. Platelet. B. Homogeneous. There is C. Plasma. Letter D. Heterogeneous. Makita nimo tanan ang mga ingredients. What kind of mixture is that? The correct answer is letter D, heterogeneous mixture. Question number 4. Refer to the illustration. Which of the following best describes it? A. It is a homogeneous mixture. Letter B. It is a heterogeneous mixture. Letter C. It is an example of a solution. Or letter D. It is neither homogeneous nor heterogeneous mixture. The correct answer for number 4 is letter B. It is a heterogeneous mixture. Question number 5. Which is or are homogeneous mixture? A. 1 only. B. 2 and 1 only. Letter C. 2 and 5 only. Or letter D. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The correct answer for number 5 is letter C. 2 and 5. So meaning sa 2 and 5, pineapple juice and coffee. Question number 6. In a solution, the substance that is being dissolved is the A. Solid, B. Salt, C. Solute, D. Solvent. The correct answer is, ang natunaw, being dissolved, solute, correct. Number 7. Bronze, steel, and brass are examples of solution. Which of the following describes these solutions? A. These are solid in liquid solution. B. These are liquid in liquid solution. Letter C. These are solid in solid solution. Or letter D. These are gas in gas solution. The correct answer for number 7 is letter C. These are solid in solid solution. Question number 8. What happens if you mix tea powder with hot water? Letter A, the tea powder will form a layer. Letter B, the tea powder will dissolve in hot water. Letter C, the tea powder will not dissolve in hot water. Or letter D, the tea powder will settle at the bottom of the hot water. The correct answer for number 8 is letter B, the tea powder will dissolve in hot water. Matunaw ang tea powder sa init nga tubig. Number 9, what is considered as the universal solvent? A, buko juice, B, water, C, paint, or letter D, acetone. The correct answer for number 9 is, of course, water. Number 10, which of the following describes the characteristics of solvent? A, the mixing of different substances, B, the substance that does the dissolving in a solution, C, the substance that is being dissolved in a solution, or letter D, the process in which neutral molecules lose or gain electrons. The correct answer for number 10 is letter B, the substance that does the dissolving in a solution. Which sugar will dissolve quickest? Diindra ko no sa picture na ang kalamay pinakamadali matunaw. Okay, dapat i-analyze ni mong maayo class para maka-answer ka sa number 11. No? Letter A. So, yang kamot, no? Sign na siya nga gilugay niya or gistir niya ang mixture. Kining kutsara dire, mauni nagapakita nga ang kalamay dugmok, no? Or small particles. Tapos, ang kining naadri nga label is 80 degrees Celsius ang kainiton. Okay? Ang kainiton sa tubig. Now, letter A. 80 degrees Celsius ang kainiton. Tapos, yapang gistir o ang dugmok na kalamay ang gibutang. Letter B. Same siya sa letter A nga, ang kainiton niya is 80 degrees Celsius. Gistir niya. Pero, ang yadaring kalamay, buo. And then, letter C, 80 gapon degrees Celsius, pareho sa letter A o sa letter B. Pero, wala na gistir. Okay, wala na yung kamot na rin ang simbolo. Pero, ang iyahang kalamay dugmok pod, no? Or small particles. Letter D, may gamay ang temperatura, 60 degrees Celsius ra. Kayun, gistir niya, and then solid pa pod ang kalamay. Now, diindiri sa picture, ang pinakamadali matunaw ang kalamay. The correct answer for number 11 is letter A. No, gistir na niya. Tapos, init ang iyang tubig and then small particles ang kalamay. No? Kung tagaan kag problem yung unani class, i-analyze yung dugmaayo ni mo, no? Para maka-answer ka. Question number 12. What else can I do to make the salt in my soap dissolve faster? A. Add a lot of table salt. B. Stir. C. Add heat. Or letter D. Let it sit. What's the correct answer? Para mas madali pamatunaw ang asin sa imuhang sabaw. The correct answer is letter B, stir imuhang lugayon. Next, number 13. What happens when you try to make a mixture of salt and oil? Okay, usay matabo kung atong i-mix kla ang asin sa mantika. A, it becomes a homogeneous solution. The salt dissolves into the oil. Meaning, ma-homogeneous siya. Tapos, matunaw ang asin sa oil. Letter B, it becomes a heterogeneous mixture. Ma-heterogeneous mixture siya. The salt doesn't dissolve into the oil. Dili ko nung matunaw ang salt sa oil. Letter C, the oil can only dissolve a little bit of salt. Meaning, matunaw lang niya ang gagmay nga part sa asin. Or letter D, none of this. Wala dyan ko nung sa letter A, B, ang kung C ang correct answer. So, what is the correct answer for number 13? The correct answer is letter B, it becomes a heterogeneous mixture. The salt does not dissolve into the oil. Kakita mo magprito ka class ang isda. Okay? So, makita nimo sa kalaha na ang asin, no? Wala natunaw sa mantika. Next, number 14. Which of the following is not a factor affecting the solubility of the solute in a solvent? A. Manner of stirring. B. Amount of solvent. C. Amount of moisture. Letter D. Temperature of solvent. So, diindira dili nila factor sa solubility. The correct answer is amount of moisture. Next, number 15. Why mixture is important? Ganong kinanglanon man nato ang mixture? A. It guides us where we go. B. It is used for producing sound. C. It helps us to create new things. Or letter D. It solves mathematical problem. The correct answer for number 15 is letter C. It helps us to create new things. No? Maka-imbento ta o mga bagong mga butang. Just like sa mga pagkao, no? Magsagol-sagol ka dira, maka-imbento na ka o bagong mga putahe. Next, number 16. Which term best describes solution? A. Homogeneous. B. Heterogeneous. C. Suspension. Or letter D. Colloid. The correct answer is homogeneous. No, ang solution ay class homogeneous mixture. Question number 17. In a solution, the substance that dissolves another substance is called blank. A. Salt. B. Solid. C. Solute. Or letter D. Solvent. The correct answer is, of course, solvent. No, ang manog tunaw. Next, number 18. What happens when you try to mix mixture of salt and water? A. It becomes heterogeneous mixture. The salt doesn't dissolve into the water. Letter B, it becomes a mixture solution. The salt dissolves into the water. Letter C, the water can only dissolve a bit of salt. Or letter D, none of this. The correct answer is letter B, it becomes homogeneous solution because the salt will dissolve into the water. Matunaw ang salt sa tubig. Number 19, which of the following is the example of solution? A. Marshmallow. B. Butter. C. Pizza. Or letter D. Air. The correct answer is air. So again, air is a solution because air is made up of different gases such as nitrogen, oxygen, and other gases like carbon dioxide. Next, number 20, which of the following is an example of gas in a liquid solution? A. Soft drink. B. Buko juice. C. Mayonnaise. Or letter D. Whipped cream. The correct answer for number 20 is soft drinks. No? Gas in a liquid solution. May mga carbon dioxide na susunod sa liquid sa soft drink. Next, number 21. Which does not describe a colloid? A. It is a suspension that turns to solution. B. It is one of the primary types of mixture. Letter C, colloid particles may be seen in a beam of light. Or letter D, it is a type of mixture in which solid or liquid particles are dispersed uniformly throughout a gas, liquid, or solid. The correct answer for number 21 is letter A, it is a suspension that turns into solution. So, dili ni siya, gasulti parte sa colloid. Number 22, which of the following is an example of colloid? A, air. B. Fog. Letter C. Vinegar. Or letter D. Salt water. The correct answer is fog. Fog is an aerosol. An aerosol is one of the kinds of colloid. Number 23. Aerosol is a colloidal state of a solid or liquid that disperses in a gas, which describes the importance of colloid in the environment. A. For transferring nutrients over short and long distance. Letter B. For increasing temperature of the environment. Letter C, for eliminating bad substances in the air. Or letter D, for segregating the garbage. The correct answer is letter A, for transferring nutrients over short and long distance. Kita ka na mga spray class na sa mga insecticides, na sa mga plantations. Okay, sa mga tubo, for example. No? So, gagamit na sila mga aerosol sa kung diin ang mga nutrients. Okay? Or kanang ilahang mga pataba, no? Kaya na mga ginaspray nila para may mga wala ang mga insects, no? It would travel a long distance in a short period of time. That's why the correct answer for number 23 is letter A. Number 24, what phenomenon occur when dispersed colloid particles scatter light? A. Tidal effect. B. Shaft effect. C. Tyndall effect. Or letter D. Miscible effect. The correct answer is A. Tyndall effect. Number 25, what is the most abundant particle in a colloid? A. Dispersing mediums. B. Dispersing phases. C. Immiscible. Or letter D. Miscible. The correct answer for number 25 is dispersing medium. Number 26, what is the difference between a suspension and a solution? A. a suspension is denser than a solution. B, a suspension is less dense than solution. A, a suspension is heterogeneous while a solution is homogeneous. Letter D, a suspension is homogeneous while a solution is heterogeneous. The correct answer for number 26 is letter C, a suspension is heterogeneous while a solution is homogeneous. Number 27, what is one property of a suspension that is different from that of a solution or a colloid? A, if left to rest, the particles of a suspension will settle down. B, the particles of a suspension reflect light. Letter C, a suspension is always clear. Letter D, suspensions are colorless. The correct answer for number 27 is letter A, left to rest, the particles of a suspension will settle down. Unlike sa solution na madissolve, kung si colloid, madisperse man lang ang mga particles that will not settle down. Number 28, why should medicine prepared as suspension be shaken well before use? A, to mix the powder drug that may be settled at the bottom. B, to make sure that good flavor is mixed. C, to make the drug into colloid. Or letter D, to make a complete solution. What's the correct answer for number 28? Letter A, to mix the powder drug that may have been settled at the bottom. Number 28, you mix sand into a bottle filled with water. The water looked cloudy, but after a while, the water looked clear. How did this happen? A, sand appeared evenly in the water. Letter B, sand settled at the bottom. Letter C, sand dissolved in water. Or letter D, sand evaporates. The correct answer for number 29 is letter B, sand settled at the bottom. Number 30, which of the following does not describe suspension? A, suspension is a kind of mixture where visible particles can be seen to the naked eyes as it settles down at the bottom when left undisturbed. B, suspension mixtures of cloudy appearance appears when two materials were mixed. C, suspension is the effect of light scattering. If no light is shown, then it is a true solution. D, suspension can be used in processing food, beverages, and medicine. The correct answer is letter C. Suspension is the effect of light scattering. If no light is shown, then it is a true solution. So that refers to Tyndall effect. Okay, what is your score, class? The passing score is 18. Okay, congratulations for passing our first summative test. Okay, this time we will check your assessment in the first lesson for Module 2. The topic is about filtering and sieving. Okay, still in your notebook, okay, you have there your answers in the assessment part of your Lesson 1 for Module 2. Okay, please get it now. Okay, if you have your module, okay, you can open it on page 6 to 7. But if you do not have, then please refer here on screen. Let's have question number 1. What method of separating mixtures will you use if you want to remove small shells in a grind or ground coffee? A, filtering. B, sieving. C, evaporation. Or letter D, decantation. The correct answer for number 1 is letter B, sieving. Number 2, which of the following mixtures use filter cloth to separate solid from a liquid extract? A, flour with stones. B, powder chalk with seeds. Letter C, baby powder with pebbles. Or letter D, milk from grated coconut. Okay, sa diindira nila, ang mugamit og filter cloth. Okay, so kinanglan solid og liquid ang i-separate. The correct answer is letter D, no, ginataan, no, or ang sapal ug ang gata. Question number 3, in filtering technique of separating mixtures, what type of material passes through a filter paper or cloth? A, liquid. B, gas. C, solid. Or letter D, plasma. Unsa man to ang mo pass through or mo lusot sa filter paper? Okay, kung imuha siyang i-separate ang duha ka mixture. The correct answer is letter A, liquid. Next, number 4. Yesha accidentally mixed the grind or ground rice that she will be using in making bibingka or rice cakes and puto with pebbles while looking for her other ingredients. How will Yesha remove the pebbles from the grind or ground rice? A, she will use filter paper to remove it. Letter B, she will use evaporation process to remove it. Letter C, she will use decantation process to remove it. Or letter D, she will use a sieve to remove it. The correct answer is, she will use a sieve to remove it. No? Because sieving is used to separate two solid particles with fine and bigger particles. Next, number 5. How will you separate the calamansi seeds from calamansi juice? A. By sieving, B. Picking, C. Filtering, or letter D. Sedimentation. Okay? Ideally, class, ha? Actually, you can separate calamansi juice, calamansi seed using various techniques. But ideally, so take note, calamansi seed is solid and calamansi juice is liquid. So what technique will you ideally use? The correct answer is filtering. Diba? Kayo pa filtering, liquid bang solid ang yung kinaseparate. Number 6 to 10. Sort out the mixtures inside the box and arrange them in their proper column. Pwede ra in any order from 6 to 8, no? Ang 9 ng 10, pwede po magbali-bali. Okay? Number 6, sa filtering, usa ta? Usa tang ibutang dre? So, we have alcohol and coins. Okay? So, again, liquid and solid ang ina-separate ni filtering. Next, number 7, vinegar and peanut seeds. And we have number 8 is zone rocks and coffee beans. Number 9, sieving. Sieving, waka solid, nilay line of sizes. So what's number 9? We have cornstarch and beans. And then we have tawas and bottles. So what's your score? Okay, congratulations class, no? Again, for having a very good score in our assessment. Okay, unahon sa nato, mag-discuss ang lesson 2 sa inyong module 2. Okay, so we have separating mixtures through evaporation. Okay, let's have first what I know. In your module, you can find the what I know part on page 2. Eyes on screen for those who do not have copies of the module. Okay, isulti lang ang imuhang tupag class ha. No need na to write your answer. Again, isulti na lang. Number 1, what method is used to obtain salt from seawater? A. Decantation, B. Sedimentation, C. Evaporation, or letter D. Filtering. The correct answer for number 1 is evaporation. Okay, we will discuss evaporation later on. Again, this is just a pretest. Number 2, which of the following examples undergo evaporation process? A. A pail of water under the heat of the sun. Letter B. Brushing your teeth after a meal. Letter C. Ironing clothes every weekend. Or letter D. Listening to the radio. The correct answer is Letter N. Letter N. Very good. Number 10, cooling after sweating. Correct answer is letter E. Okay? So, what's your score? Okay, okay lang na, no? Pretest pamanggod to. Okay, we will discuss all of those later on. Okay, what can you say about the picture on screen, class? Ipanggutom na mo ay. Okay? Yes, mga sudan. Okay? Now, one of the main ingredients in cooking food is unsa man ang common nila nga ginagamit sa tanan nga nila para mas may lasa kung kano na nato sila. Yes, very good. It's the salt, okay, or asin. Salt serve as an important element in our planet, no, because of its many uses. Daghan kaayo gamit ang atoang salt. Usa na na ang pag-prepare sa atoang mga sud-an adlaw-adlaw. Kaya kung ma-observeran ba ni mo ang mga asin class, no? We often see crystal white color, okay, that adds savor to our everyday meals. Okay? Mauna siyang gapa, lasa pagyod sa atoang mga sud-an. The salt is also used as a component of other products sold in the market. So again, daghan kaayo gamit ang atoang salt. Pero may idea mo, class? Paano ginahimo ang asin? How salt is made? Any idea? Di manigika ng asin. Okay, unsa ang proseso ang involved in making salt? Okay, this is through the process of evaporation. Now, would you like to know more about evaporation process? Gusto pa dyan mo makita kung paano ginahimo ang asin or ginakuha ang asin. Okay, today, our objective is to describe evaporation process as technique in separating mixtures. Are you excited? Heat is an important component to our environment. Importante kaayo ang init class nga naman. Because it makes green things live and grow abundantly. Labi na sa mga tanom class, no? They need sunlight, they need the heat from the sun, no? In producing their own food. The presence of the sun's heat serve as the main source of energy in our planet. Okay? Halos tanan, no? Na energy sa atoang planet, okay? Coming from the sunlight. So, sunlight brings many uses to biotic or the living things and abiotic or non-living things components to our surrounding. Ang mga living o non-living things, no, nanginanglan jud og heat from the sun. As heat is used by animals and plants as main source of energy, it is also useful in many things, no, in the process of evaporation. One of the techniques in separating mixture. So, ang init class, kung importante siya sa mga tanom o sa mga animals, importante po ang heat sa process na ginatawag nato na evaporation. Kabati na mo ang evaporation na word class. Okay? So, this is how to demonstrate the evaporation. No? So, please eyes here on screen para may idea ka unsa or paano ang ginatawag na evaporation. Okay, nakita ni mo ni class? Okay, this illustration class shows how evaporation is done. So as you see, evaporation takes place, no, by the help of the heat from the sun. The water evaporates and the water becomes water vapor. So kung mainitan day ang tubig class, no, matingan na lang ka nga mujutay ang tubig kay na nga, evaporate na, nahimo na og water vapor. Kay dili lang init sa adlaw class ang pwede gamiton para maka-demonstrate of evaporation. Pwede po ang init nga gikan sa imong stove or kalayo or fire. So, for example, magpakulo tag tubig. Okay, mapansin nimo kung init na kaayo? Okay, magbukal-bukal na ang tubig. Nga nung mag-boil man or magbukal-bukal man ang tubig class? It's because the water reaches the boiling point. Buti pasabot, naabot na niya ang 100 degrees Celsius na temperatura. Once maabot na niya class ang 100 degrees Celsius, bubukal gina siya o ang tubig mahimo og water vapor. Makita nimo mga aso-aso? Kanang aso class, tubig na siya. No? Tubig na siya. So, ning evaporate na. Hasta nga mahubsan ang imuhang pinakulo na nga tubig. Kung yung kasog, madugayan nimo sa palong ang imuhang stove, matingala na lang ka na wala na ipunod ang imuhang tubig. Kay na nga evaporate na. Kini class, komunikay nimo, takore, di ba? Na. So, mag-aso-aso na gani class, buti pasabot, na nga evaporate na ang tubig na naa sa imuang sulod sa takore. So, kinanglan na nimo pagnon. Kung di na nimo pagnon class, mahurot na ginang tubig sa sulod sa imuhang takore. Wa na dyan kay gamiton sa imuang pamainit. No? So, dili na siya. Kung magbukal-bukal na gani class, dili na gid na siya pa mubukal pa or muinit pag maayo. Hasta ra gina siya sa 100 degrees Celsius. After ana, mo evaporate na ang tubig. Now, what do we mean now by evaporation? So, what is evaporation? Anybody? Naka-idea? Okay, so, evaporation is a process of separating mixtures which involves heating the solution until the solvent evaporates, leaving behind the solid residue. Okay, gamit ko no ang init class, ang solution nato, ang solvent sa imuang solution, mo evaporate. Kung naamang gid siya ay mixture dira nga solid particles na nasa imong tubig, magpabili na. Kay kanang mga solid particles, gaano man na siya kapino, dili jud na siya mo evaporate. Because only liquid, no, such as water, has the ability to evaporate when it reaches its boiling point na 100 degrees Celsius. Okay. Heat is being the main component in the evaporation process. Heat separates the mixtures of solid from a liquid. As a liquid goes in the air in the form of gas when heated, changing the liquid to gas. So, kanang gas-gas mo na ginamin ako ng water vapor kanina, no? As an example of physical change. Yes, class. Physical change lang ang natabo sa tubig. Okay, wa man na nasunog ang tubig, no? Nawala lang for the meantime, nahimo lang water, gikan sa liquid, nahimo lang siya gas. But then eventually, ang kanang gas class, mahimo naman po na siyang tubig pagkaulihi. Bukad to na siya sa babaw. No, mapurma na siya ang katong water vapor, mapurma na siya clouds. Once ang cloud through the process of condensation na pud na, no? Now, kung mapuno ng tubig na ang clouds, no? So, mauna na siyang time nga ma-precipitate na pud. Precipitation na pud ang tawag ana. Okay? Sumubalik ra gyapon pagkatubig ang katong mga water nga na evaporate. That's why physical change lang ang natabo. So here are some examples of evaporation process, no? Such as in again boiling water. So there is evaporation involved here when you boil water. Okay? Kanang mga aso-aso nga nakita nimo class, tubig na, no? So ang liquid nahimo siya gas or water vapor. Another example that involves evaporation process is when you dry clothes. Yes, class. Kung painitan na nimo or ihalay na nimo ang imuhang mga nilabhan. So, nagmix ang imong nilabhan o ang tubig, di ba? So, paano nimo i-separate ang tubig sa imuhang nilabhan? Eh, siyempre, suksukod pa man na siya nimo. Yes, painitan nimo. So, again, ang heat ng gikan sa adlaw, may kakayahan nga i-evaporate niya ang tubig nga nagmix sa imuhang mga sinina. Pero ala nga naman ang sinina mo, kuan pa, mo evaporate. So wala gyud, magpabilin ra, mauga ra gyud ang imuhang mga sinina. Ang i-separate lang o i-evaporate lang ang tubig nga nasagol sa imong mga nilabhan. So that's why in that case, evaporation is used in separating the mixture of your clothes and the water. Okay ni class, kay pirmi mag-ulan, makarelate jud ka ani. No, kung mag-ulan, syempre mabasa ang dalan, di ba? So, wa ka natingala nga nung maugara? Yes! Tungod na siya sa init sa adlaw. So, para ma-separate ang tubig sa dalan or sa road, you need the sunlight because the sunlight will evaporate the water, no, through the heat of the sun. Okay, the salt also dissolve in water, no? Tanungdum pa mo nga matunaw man gyud ang asin sa tubig. Okay, this is also an example of a mixture. Okay? Specifically, if we mix salt and water, we could form a solution, di ba? Na dissolve na ang salt. Now, the question is, mabuwag pa ba ang salt sa tubig? No? Paano man na mabuwag? Nga natunaw naman ang asin sa tubig. Ya, sir, mabuwag pa rin na, sir. Mabalik pa rin ito ang asin, no? Ang natunaw na. The correct answer is, yes, pwede, class. We can separate the salt solution, no? By the process of evaporation. So again, unsa ato ang gamiton? Para mo evaporate ang tubig para magpabilin ang salt? Yes, very good. The evaporation. Kaya ang salt, class, dili man na siya liquid. No, magpabilin na gid na siya. So kung imo na siyang painitan ang tubig mo evaporate. Magpabilin ang salt. So that's why we could separate still the salt and water solution. Iba ni class ang pwede na to ubrahon para ma-separate ang salt sa tubig. Pwede na to siya pakuluan ang tubig, no? Pwede ra pod di ka mo gamit og kalayo. Pwede ra pod nimo siya ibuwad. Pero it will take some time. Sige lang, okay ra pod, pero safe ka kay walay kalayo involved, di ba? So kung naakay gihalo nga asin og tubig nya imo ang gi-dissolve ang salt sa water, imo na siyang ibutang sa init, no, pagkaugma na, matinga na lang ka nga salt na lang nabilin, nawala na ang tubig. Okay? Solution like salt water and coffee, for example, coffee pod cannot be separated by simple filtration or sieving. Dili ni sila ma-separate gamit lang ang imuhang simple nga pagsala. No? Kasi imuha pa ning salaon, class, using filter paper. Okay? Mulusot ra gyapon ni kay natunaw na lagi ang salt sa tubig. The only way to separate it is by the use of evaporation process. Okay, for you to understand better what I am saying, no, it would be better to demonstrate how evaporation process helps in separating the salt and water solution. Okay, let us watch this video clip for you to have a clear understanding on this matter. Kids, do not do this at home. This needs adult supervision. Let's mix salt and water in the beaker. Let's put the beaker with salt and water mixture in the heater. Let's stir the mixture to form homogeneous mixture. Let's heat the mixture for some time. Now, as you observe, the solution is boiling. As you notice, after a couple of minutes, the water evaporates and turns to water vapor. Leaving behind the salt. And this is how evaporation used to separate solution or homogeneous mixture. Okay, so naa na kay idea kung paano ihiwalay ang salt na natunaw sa tubig. No, again, by the process called evaporation. Pero class, akatong ipakita na ko nga video ha, dili to ninyo pwede gamiton kay ka-involve to siya og mga kalayo. Pwede man to ninyo ubrahon, no, gamay lang sulodlanan, pero ibuwad lang ninyo sa init. No? Kaya pwede naman dili kagamit og kalayo. So ibuwad lang ninyo sa init ang inyong mixture nga salt og water para ikaw mismo makabalo, no, kung gusto man jud nimo siya testingan. Pero again, wala ko ga-advise nga mogamit og kalayo in separating the mixture of salt and water. Okay? Now, Same also concept is applied in making salt glass. Yes, tubig dagat na nasgikan ang atuang mga asin. So, paano man nagikuha ang mga asin? So, again, it will be separated through the process of evaporation. I'm sure, class, you have now the idea how to use evaporation process in separating mixture such as salt from sea water. This time, we will answer the what is it part in your module. Okay, it could be found on page 5. Please eyes on screen for those who do not have copies of the module. Isulti lang ang tubag ninyo for this activity. No need to write. Ayaw na isulat. Isulti na lang. Question number 1. What is evaporation? Okay, kung may tupad ka dira, kung tupad ni mo si mama ni mo, si papa ni mo, si tito ni mo, or imuhang tigbantay, please tell him or her the meaning of evaporation. Bisan binisaya lang, no? Sige, I'll give you time to answer. Tell him para aware po siya, no? Na naadyo kayo may nakuha sa atong lesson for evaporation. Sige ko na. Okay, what is evaporation? Go! Okay, now evaporation is a process of separating mixtures in which involves heating the solution until the solvent evaporates, leaving behind the residue. Okay, gamit ang init, okay, atong painitan ng solution, ang solvent maoy na himo og water vapor o evaporate siya, ang nahabilin ang mga solid residue. Next, number 2. What is needed to achieve evaporation process? Unsa ang kinahanglan para ma-achieve ang evaporation process? Unsa to gani? O sige, isulti sa imong tupad. Yan. Heat. The correct answer is heat, no? Heat is needed to achieve evaporation process. Very good. Question number 3. Give 3 examples of situation where evaporation process was observed. Oh, tagaan takang example kanina, class, no? Kung diin pwede magamit ang evaporation. Oh, sige, dumdumi ko na be. Tulo lang. Sugiri ang imuhang tupad dira, no? Kung unsa or paano ginagamit ang evaporation. Go! Sa diin pa ginagamit ang evaporation, tulo lang ah. Tulo lang ang isabat. Okay. So again, ang answer ni mo, pwede rin po wala diri sa screen. Okay? But this is the common example how evaporation process is observed or used. Boiling water. Magpakulo kang tubig. Drying of clothes. Maghalay ka og nilabhan. Drying of wet roads after a heavy rain. Okay? And also, in salt making. No? Makubarak asin, pwede. Next, question number 4. What kind of material is left behind when mixture is heated? Unsang material, unsang klaseng material, specifically what phase of matter is left, katong mabilin, kung na-evaporate na ang tubig. Unsang mabilin? Isulti. Oh, sulti si mong tubad. Sulti ni mama or ni papa. Sige. That's the answer. Yes, solid. Now, the correct answer is solid. Solid material left behind when mixture is heated. Next, question number 5. What kind of change is involved in evaporation process? So, ito ganing klaseng change? Okay, unsang ang klaseng change ang involved? No? In evaporation process. The correct answer is duha ra man ang klase, class. Physical or chemical change. Yung habi ng klase pa grade 5. No? Kanumdumo. So, unsang ang klase nga change ang involved in the evaporation process? Is it chemical change or physical change? Okay, the correct answer is physical change is involved in evaporation process. Nailisan lang ang purma sa water, nahimulag water vapor, pero tubig ra gyapon na siya, kaya mahimo man siya ulan. No? Tubig ra gyapon. Chemical change, man good class, kung ka na nasunog dyan siya, nung laing yun ang itsura, just like sa papel. Pag sunog ni mo, mubalik pa nagpapel, di ba, kay abo naman na? Na, that's why chemical change to siya. Ang physical change, muilis lang yung purma kadali, pero mubalik ra, just like sa tubig. No, tubig na siya, nahimog water vapor kadali, pero mubalik ra gyapon siyang tubig, no, kung mahimo na siya og ulan. Okay, next. Let's have the what's more part of your module. Let's have the what's more part of your module. This could be found on page 5. Please eyes here on screen for those who do not have copies of the module. Okay, directions. Read the conditions stated in the box. Pick out those that undergo evaporation process. On iBox class, mupili ka, diindira nila ang gagamit or undergo evaporation. Okay, diin ko na. Sige. Sige. So we have... Oh, sige, we have cooking noodles. Okay, isulti lang Japon ang subang class ha. Ito, sulti lang Japon para di na ka magsulat. Next. Cooling after sweating. No? Panington ka, nyadugidugay, mawa yung mong singot. Ha? Hing evaporate man. Next. We have drying of sand after the rain. Oh, kung mabasa ang balas, maugara. Pagkahuman, mainitan. Next, boiling of mungo beans or mungo seeds. No? Kung pakuluan ni mo ang mungo, no? Magpakulo ganun ka class, siyempre gamit ka tubig. So ang tubig, mo evaporate ka ng aso, ding evaporate na siya. Okay, some more. Oh, pila na lang nabilin. We have drying of plate after washing. Ah, kanang mag hugas ka, mahuman ka hugas mga pinggan, di ba? Nauga ang pinggan. Next, we have salt making. Ah, so magkubra ka og asin. Okay, napay nabilin? May usa pa. Okay, we have cooking rice. So nang cooking rice? Yes, magluto ka og kanipon. Okay, so again, these are the following conditions that evaporation process could be used. Let's have the what I have learned part of your module. This could be found on page 6 of your module. Eyes here on screen for those na walay kopya sa module. Isulti lang ang sapat, dili na dapat kopyahon, okay? Complete the following ideas. I learned that evaporation is a process of separating mixtures which involves, samang answer nila, sa first lang, involves heating the solution, correct, until the solvent, maunsa man ang solvent, basta mainit na, evaporates, very good, leaving behind, unsa mabilin, solid residue, very good. This time, let us answer the what I can do part in your module. The what I can do part of your module can still be found in page 6. Okay, again, isulti lang gyapon ang sabat. Hindi na kinanglan pa isulat. In a grade 6 science class, a group of pupils would like to separate salt from water. What method will they use to separate the mixture? Explain your answer. Zakaha, ang pwede. Yes, no, obviously. The answer is? Yes, evaporation. Next, question number 2. In the illustration shown below, explain a few sentences, the techniques of separating mixtures, and give the benefit of separating it. Oh, unsa nga separating mixture technique ang ato ang gamiton? Gamit ang illustration nga makita sa screen. Okay, obviously again, evaporation. Okay, paano man? The heat from the sun will help drying up your clothes, makatabang siya para mauga ang imong mga nilabahan. Kaya ang water will be separated and will be evaporated when heated by the use of sunlight. Benefit, as I said, that would be drying of your clothes, no? Eh, para na kay suksukon. Okay? So, kung walay sunlight, medyo mabudlayan ka, mabaho ba na class ang mga nilabhan, no? Kung alang-alang siya sa pag-uga, no? Kung ligitanan ng mga tubig na sa imong nilabhan, mo evaporate, mabaho na ang nilabhan class. Pero karon, kung mga lain ng chimpo, usually, may mga washing machine na class na naanay mga dryer. Okay? So, ginabutang nila sa dryer, mauga na dahil ng ilang nilabhan. Pero kung katong mga walay dryer, of course, mag-rely ra gyud ta sa init sa adlaw. Speaking of wash clothes class, kinsa man ang kapanglabas sa inyong balay? Nya, gatabang ka ni mama o ni papa ni mo sa pagpanglaba o pag-ubra sa sulod balay? Okay, very good. If you are helping your mother or your father doing household chores, what value are you possessing? The value of helpfulness. Very good. Dapat class, ginatabangan nimo si mama o si papa nimo sa pag-ubra sa sulod balay. Ug importante pod na makabalo ka sa mga ubra sa panimalay samtang bata ka pa. Okay? So I guess you are now ready to take your assessment. Now, the direction is read each item carefully. Write your answer in your 1/4 sheet of paper. Kini class, di na kinalan isulti ha? So, kinanglan isulat na ninimo. Okay? 1/4 lang. Again class, dili na katong i-ansiran to ganina, kalabi na sa inyo hanggi pang sulti ng mga sabat, dili na to nimo siya ipasa. Ang ipasa nimo, usa sa ipasa nimo, kini na lang yung assessment. 1/4 lang ha, ayaw to tagayan ng 1 hole kay dako ra pug kaayong 1 hole, sayang ang papel. So please use 1/4 sheet paper only in answering your assessment. So 1/4 ang ipasa, dili na ang 1 hole. Sa katong may mga module, makita nimo ang assessment sa page 7 to page 8. Okay, katong mga walay module, please eyes here on screen now. Biskan may module pa ka class, kinanglan sa 1/4 lang japong kamo answer. Balag answer ka sa module kay muha man na, pero answer jug ka kopyahan japon nimo sa 1/4. Kay ang 1/4 biya ang ipasa nimo, dili biya ang module, okay? Kay muha naman ang module, dira na lang na sa imuha. Katong may mga module, okay? No need to pass your module to me, but you have to submit your 1/4, okay? So again, write the letter only. Dili na dapat kopyahon. For number 6 to 10 class, put check before the number if the technique used is evaporation and X if not. Okay? So, pwede ra po, dili na kopyahon ang 6 to 10. Answer na lang. Check og X na lang. Pasa kaysa notebook ra ni siya ang siran. Okay, please copy this in your notebook. Kuha palihog kayo mong notebook and then kopyahon nimo ang additional activities. Sunod si mana class, mag-summative test na punta. No? Ang lesson 1 o ang lesson 2 sa imuhang module 2 sa science. Okay? Katong lesson 1, katong sieving and filtering. O ang karong lesson 2, party sa evaporation. So, mauni atong coverage sa ato ang summative test sa sunod semana. Unsa man ang ipasa class sa Biyernes? Ang imuha ra jung 1/4 sa assessment sa module 2 lesson 2 evaporation. Wala na joy lain class ha. So dapat ang ihatag ninyo ni mama ninyo nga inugpasa sa Biyernes ang kana ra jung 1/4. Dili ko mudawat og 1 whole. 1/4 ra gyud nga papel ako ang dawaton. Okay, please get your science notebook again class. Please copy important concepts on our lesson for evaporation. So please get your notebook now and copy the important concepts in science about evaporation in your notebook. Okay, please get it now. So these are the pointers for our summative test next week. Okay? Filtering, sieving, and evaporation. Okay, kung gusto ninyo class, malantaw ang mga past na to nga videos, even ang present na to nga mga video lessons, kadto lang mo sa www.ss.info. This is our official website for Escalante Central Elementary School. Na dali menu bar sa babaw, pwede nyo na maklik, no? Ang mga videos na to from kindergarten to grade 6. Okay? And also, please be reminded to please tune in to our Radyo Atraca every day for our radio-based instructions. And also, please do watch our TV-based instruction, Channel IBC. But if you missed the episodes, you can watch it at YouTube. Okay? Subscribe DepEd TV on YouTube. Okay? To keep updated for all the video lessons of our TV-based instructions. Okay? If you have questions also, class, you can contact me during our offline and online kamustahan that is scheduled every Wednesday, 2:30 to 3:30 in the afternoon. So please do contact me on our scheduled dates and time. In case class na medyo magka-diferensya atong USB, di siya ma-play, yadi po kaka-access atong website, sa YouTube channel nako, pwede ni mo siya malantaw ang mga science video lessons. Okay? The past and present na to ng mga lessons, no? Naratanan sa akong YouTube channel, Tutorial by Sir Raymond. If you want, you can subscribe to my channel para, biskang di na ni mo siya i-search, automatic, na siya diradayon sa imuhang YouTube. Please, do subscribe my channel to keep updated on my video lessons. Okay, that's all for this week, class. Thank you so much, and I hope you followed all the instructions and all the activities we had for this week in science. I congratulate you for a job well done. By the way, I received your vlog, no? Video vlog, mga drawings ninyo, mga infomercial ninyo last week, and I am quite impressed, okay? So good job for that, okay? So have a blessed week, everyone. Stay home, class, and stay safe. Go.